Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at New Hope, a word macrovirus that had the potential to be destructive. However, at some point the author had an apparent change of heart, and we'll take a look at what I mean by that in just a bit. We'll go ahead and start things off by launching the Word document, which installs the infected macro, of course, which overwrites our normal template, so every Word document thereafter will also be infected, and you can just get right on out of here, Clippy. We don't need you for this video. We're going to go ahead and actually look at our macros, and we see there aren't any, which is kind of suspicious for a macro virus video, but it does not block our Visual Basic editor, where we can see there actually is Visual Basic code embedded in this document. So we can see our program name is something, I don't know it. You guys were able to decipher what it actually was supposed to be saying in the last macro virus video I did, so if you could do that again, that would be cool. And we can see it goes through here. It disables virus protection if you have it enabled on Word. It also installs it to the normal template, as we can see here. And if it's installed, then it goes to its payload routine, which activates on a, supposed to be a random month, but it always ends up being September. And we can see here this commented out line that wants to kill all the files in trend PCSylin98, which is an antivirus utility. But at some point, the author decided that was just too much, so we had to take that part out. So now that we've taken a look at this code, go ahead and get out of here, and close out of it, and switch the date over so we can actually see what happens. So September 1st, and we run it, and we get this nice, really cool neon border going on here, and some text that I can't read. Once again, if you can enlighten me, I would appreciate it. And now the fun begins. I am typing a sentence for my report, period. But it's no longer a period. It's something just indescribable. It's just an explosion of text. If we enlarge it, we can see it better. This report would be good. Good. Comma. Crazy things. Let's see. But crazy things are happening. I promise you, the period is broken again, but I promise you I can into English when I want to. So other than this, the virus is relatively benign, other than spreading to other documents here. We'll demonstrate that. We'll call this one test. We will save it on our desktop as test. We'll close out of it. Yes, we'll save the changes. If we look at test, it's also been infected. And we can also just create a totally new document here, start a new instance of Word, write blah blah blah, period. Period's still broken because our normal template is infected. And when we save this, this will also add the text. Well, it does sometimes. Hold on. We're breaking. There it is. Okay, the text is here. So, if you were to finish your report with weird periods and commas and all that crap, and send it to your teacher, that Word document would be infected, and you would infect your teacher's computer when they opened it on their computer, and all of their future lesson plans would wind up looking something like this. Or if you put your text in this glowing green box, you can make it look like this. So if you have a report due that's based on, you know, like number of pages that you've written, this is a really quick way to get there pretty fast. Like, I'm just holding down comma or period, and you can tap them if you want, you can do whatever. But this is my tip to you. Utilize the viruses on your machine. Don't destroy them. Embrace them. Sometimes they might be useful. So one last thing to take a look at with this virus is that we can actually restore the destructive capabilities that the author originally intended this virus to have. We'll go ahead and go into our code, and we'll just take this line out of here. We'll just put it right down here. So when the payload activates, it should delete all the files in this folder. Now, I don't actually have this antivirus installed, so let's just create a dummy folder here. Okay, we got our folder, and we'll just make some files. Text document, why not? Hey, a Word document, that's relevant. And a wave sound, cool. So we got our three documents in this folder. We'll go ahead and rerun our macro now that this line exists. And we should hopefully see these files disappear. Yep, they're gone. RIP. Goodbye, get out of here, farewell, you won't be missed. And that is really about it for New Hope. It's not too complicated as you've seen, it's only a few dozen lines of code. as most macro viruses are, but as it is apparent, it is easy to edit, which could make any of these macro viruses pretty dangerous, because they could pretty easily wipe out a lot of files on your machine very quickly. So, that is it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Take care.